All right. Well, it is Christmas. And it rained yesterday, good portion of the day, so we're out here with epic soil conditions. Good old hero dirt. Buddies going the other way. Ooh, yep, hero dirt. Feels good. Feels real good. Some of them worn out tires now are darn near at the very, very end of their life. Here is today. He's on a brand new set of tires he's never ridden before. He's on the Bridgestone X30 up front. And Dunlop MX-33 rear. He's got a race coming up at a lot of motocross track action and fast sand wash, so don't blame him. Probably be a good combo for up there. We'll see. What do you think of him today? I'm going to try him. Or I should say try out his bike here later. What I think of. Start off with 12 PSI front and rear. Whoa, my front just tried to slide out in hero dirt. Gonna love that. See how I do. I'm still on the Tusk Recon front. It is lost knobs like crazy on the edges. And yeah, I'm not happy with the tire, that's for sure. Just yet. I was going to try the Maxxis SI, but holy cow, the price on the Maxxis tires have gone through the freaking roof, man. When I can buy a Golden tire cheaper than I can a Maxxis, that's ridiculous. So, no Maxxis SI right now. I don't know what the problem is with their pricing, but won't be running them. So it's going to be back to the Golden Tire Fatty. Think I'm going to stick with the 220 Ride Gummy Rear. So I'm really digging the longevity compared to the IRC. And I'm also digging its sand traction over the B33S IRC tire. So I think that's what I'm gonna stick with the rear, go back to my Golden tire, see what I think compared now. I've ridden on another front for a while. We'll see how it pans out. As you can tell, look at this chocolate cake soil. Beautiful. Beautiful soil. Watch out for the branches. Watch that. Blow out on me. Don't trust it. Recon is not the best of the sand. Now that it's worn down. Kind of a liability, I think. I wrote it today. Now we're on the dead cow. We don't ride this trail as much as we used to. Only a tiny little section of it. Looks like we're gonna ride the whole thing today. I think that's what Mr. Beers has planned. This is gonna be interesting. Be doing okay on those tires so far, but then again, like I said, the soil is kind of a, it's not a good example of what we normally get to ride. If he remembers all the little ways that the Jeeps / side-by-sides have destroyed this trail. It's hard to find the trail in a couple spots because of it, their damage. White guys feel they have to poach single track is beyond me. Below 50% tread, it's doing pretty damn good. Very pleased. Gotta love this tire. And I can tell he's kind of lost. Let's see if he gets it. See if he gets it. Yep. Woo! Nothing like being out on Christmas riding a dirt bike. It's confusing all the damage they've done. As you can see, this used to be This used to be 100% single track. Look at it. They've destroyed it. Absolutely have destroyed it. Bastards. But he did make that turn. He knew it was coming. Good job, Mr. Bears. Getting better. You might actually learn Miranda one of these days. Anyway, being that it's Christmas, try and stay positive. Since it's a beautiful day out to ride. Missing the family. Oh yeah, gotta love this. Ooh. What is it? God dang, looks nasty. Not horrible. Don't know why I'm freaking out on it. That's normally stuff that ain't a problem. I mean, uphills. Daniel sketch me out sometimes. I admit. Which I normally used to sketch out bears too, but he seems to be doing a lot better with them. Alright. Okay. Anyway, being on the positive stuff, wish I could get to see my family for Christmas, but sadly, majority of them live in Indiana and Kentucky, so I don't get to see them. This is a bummer. That turn. Wow. Totally destroying this single track. Freaking bastards. Wow. So much destruction. Okay, positive. Anyway, at least I know my family's healthy and doing okay right now, which is what's important to me the most. That's a good thing. Woo-hoo. Sorry, concentrating on the rocks and everything. Shame this was such a beautiful single track at one point. But as I try and be positive. I said my family's doing okay, which is most important. So I'm pretty happy about that. This was a fun little tight twisty thing. And they ruined it. Gotta be side by side. I think he caught himself. That's good job. Yeah. action out here for the most part. Get careful here. He just dove in it. He's getting better than me. The downhills, you never know what it's like after it's rained out here, so I admit I'm being a little cautious. Never go anything without knowing what's coming. Or at least have a basic idea. Too slow there. That's been a bad place. Alright. Had me worried there for a second. Anyway, my big thing is I hope everybody's families are doing good. Hopefully 2022 will be a better year than the past couple. We'll see what happens. I think it's gotta be better, right? It's gotta be. Can't get a whole lot worse. Well, I guess it could, but... Let's hope for the best. How about that, huh? Let's do that. Alright. Getting through it. That's all that matters. I hope to have some more fun here on the dirt bike. I got some plans in the works, which I think some of you might be interested. I'm trying to invest in the tooling and such that I'm going to be bringing a few parts to market. If anybody's interested, let me know. So I'm thinking about currently, well, I'm starting to build a CDIs, adjustable CDIs for the KDX 200 and 220. So if you're interested in one of those, let me know. Also have developed a electric start system. Now that is in the preliminary testing stages, R&D stages. Pretty sure I have it scienced out, but I gotta get some parts made, which is why I need to invest in some machinery. But hopefully I know we got a buddy up in Canada with a lathe and said he could turn some parts for me. That's the hardest part, is the one part I need done on a lathe for the starting system. Whoa! A little slick right there. So I gotta figure that part out, get it all scienced out, dimensions and everything. And I might send it to him, or I just might buy my own lathe. I've been thinking about buying a decent lathe and a small mill, because I don't need a mill for much of anything. But a few things would be nice. one of the benchtop types, what they call them, mini mills, would do what I need. It's like a bigger lathe though than a mini, even though I guess what I get would still be considered a mini. So we'll see how that plays out. Nasty stick. Keep going on dead cow, okay. Yep, we're doing the whole dead cow loop. That's cool. We don't do it very often. Looks like we're the only ones on it so far today too, on this section. Cool. Fresh. Like Subway. Actually, the Subway ain't the very fresh one that I've tasted, but not a fan of it. But anyway, yeah, so I got this pretty much figured out in my head and on paper. But of course, until you actually make it, make parts, put it in the wild and test it, which I'll be testing on my bike. And I might have one or two other out there I might send out to people, just have them abuse it. So I am going to be looking for somebody to abuse the hell out of it. Try and get them to, you know, fail. So I can find out what weak parts, or weak points, weak parts, whatever you want to call it, is on the system. And address those issues and make it better. I do plan on making them available for sale. The one thing that most people really wish for the KDX. Also planning on making a heavy duty plastic skid plate, very similar to what GM Designs makes. I don't like the only other plastic version available on the market for KDXs, which is the one from Hyde. Not disparaging Hyde at all. They make good products from what I've seen. I just don't like that particular style of plastic skid plate. So I'm gonna make my own heavy duty. And once I get my electric start too, I'm gonna build one that's meant to work with it. So it'll be, you know, won't be leaving the electric starter out there on its own to get damaged so easy. Well, the starter will be protected, but protect the housing for the starter, you know. So we'll see what I come up with. Also want to make chain guides as well. Nobody makes them for the KDX. A plastic one. Ooh. Tell the water ran through here. See, these downhills always sketch me out after it's rained. I'm very cautious. And of course I don't trust my front tire, which definitely doesn't help. So, yeah, we'll see how that goes with the plastic skid plate and chain guide. Like I said, I got some ideas for that as well. I'm going to offer a few other KDX specialty items. An upgraded brake pedal with a billet aluminum tip. Much better grip, because I know mine really sucks. My boots get wet on rainy days, real muddy or wet out. It's a real problem. So I want to get that fixed. build a custom, and I'm also going to build a clutch arm extension, or extended clutch arm, actuator arm, to make the KDX clutch pull lighter, and it'll also give it better modulation. Because for me, I mean, you can modulate the KDX clutch, but it's a very, very narrow window. So I want to open that up a little bit, make it a little more of a window, so you can get better modulation on it when in technical hunts and such. On him now. As he kind of had to check up a little bit. Guess I could ride a little more aggressive. But yeah, I got some ideas on products for the KDX, and honestly, I just feel like doing it because I love dirt bikes. And there's things that are not offered for my bike. For this bike, I should say, the KDX, which is, a lot of people love these KDXs. Well, I'd like to bring the KDX into the more modern era with electric start. And see if I can get it to its longevity to last a little longer in today's world. There's one thing about a KDX. You just take care of them, change the oil, and regular maintenance crap. Honestly, these bikes will last darn near forever. They're just that indestructible. So if you got a junk one, it's because that bad boy was abused and put away wet. I mean, it was treated bad. Probably has who knows how many thousands of hours on the same top end kind of thing. Woo! That's the end of the dead cow.